What's up, everybody? Jason here for JaspysCaseBreaks.com. 2022 Bowman Baseball Jumbo 8-box case break. Pick your teams number 4 just sold out. And here we go, guys. So if you have a little character at the end of your name, that means you want that from a team random filler. Everybody else bought in straight up. And there's everybody there. And we got a Bowman Jumbo. So this one should be a little bit more exciting because there is 3 autos per box. Bella. And we'll do 4 boxes each, just like I did for the hobby, 6 boxes each, and we'll stop and go through the hits and whatnot, and then continue on. But hobby with no pack stacking help took me about 1 hour and 8 minutes. I think with Joe with pack stacking help, it took him 55 minutes. So a jumbo, it took him 1 hour with pack stacking help, I believe. So I assume that I should be around the same time frame as him, about 1 hour or so. So I think there's 250 cards in a hobby box, while here I think there is 12 packs, 32 cards. So definitely more cards per box, but he ends up almost evening out. All right, looks like Carl actually sold it out. So we'll be doing first off the line to end the night off, guys. Sweet. I don't know, Battle. I'm actually not. I mean, I know a lot of people say Colorado. Think maybe Tampa Bay could repeat or three-peat, but Florida, I don't know, man. They were the best team last year, this season. I haven't played too well this playoffs. Carolina finally dropped one, so they're up 2-1 now. Colorado's up 2-1 now, too, right? Or 2-0. Or 3-0, actually. I think they won today, right? Yeah. I don't know. I guess it depends on what teams get upset in this first round. And then we can kind of get maybe a clearer picture. Wait, no way, Aaron. Canelo lost. No, he didn't. Did he? I was just joking, really. Really? Well, then today was the upsets day. Well, you have to assume he's going to want to rematch this guy. Right? Well, if they bet for the guy. Yeah, I think I was just looking around on Twitter. Darren Ravel says sportsbooks cleaned up tonight on Canelo's fight. Who loses to Dimitri Bivol? Offered Bivol to win market at +400. Only 9% of that money was on him. Well, I think he moved up to middle. Yeah, it says undisputed super middleweight moves up to light heavyweight. I guess, obviously, that's a big change. Alright, guys, here you go. Half a case is right here. Let's roll. So we're just going to kind of skip through that again. So the shipping team would basically pull out any rookies or first that we're going to be sending out and stuff like that. Just in the interest of time, of course, for the break. And here's first relic, Backstrom, or sorry, not relic, but Speckle, number to 299. There's our first autograph. Suwinski for Pittsburgh. No, of course not bad. Honestly, I love the sound of ripping wax packs, man. It's soothing. I think down the road, my hands will probably have like carpal tunnel and stuff like that, but no, man, I love it. Ripping packs is like the best sound. Nick Gonzalez. And we got Albright's little atomic to 100. And to $4.99, Angeles first for San Diego. And we got Henry Mendez. Paper Luis Joe. Xbox. Bailey for the Sox. We got Jonathan Clays. That's to $2.99. Christian Santana and Christian Gonzalez, Bowman's first purple to 250 for the Houston Astros. Top load those here once we finish all four boxes. And that's Houston. That's going to Jen. Oh. Oh, man. She went the hell out of my arm. And Frazier for Pittsburgh to $4.99. Oh shoot. Malcolm Nunez. Paper, Urbina. All right, next box. We have a Genovis, Ricardo Genovis to $2.99 for the G-Men Giants. Wilson. And we have a Larza, Andre Larza to 75 for Washington going to Travis. Got that from a team random. And Oswaldo Cabrera for the Yankees. Let's go to Anthony. We got Tyler Soderstrom to 150, Shimmer Blue. Jordan Walker. All right, guys, last box, then we'll go to the next four. Carlos Aguilar. Otto Lopez. And another Lara, this time blue, for Washington going to Travis. We got a first, Dominguez. Ed Howard to 250. I do. I think it is going to be a multi-million dollar card. I do. It's probably going to be the most sought out modern card ever, like, in history. And, yeah, I think anybody that really wants it and has that money, especially as a high-end collector, because there are some really high-end collectors out there, this is a card that you're going to want to pay up for, honestly. I think it'll be multi-million. I think it is three. We got Henry Davis to 150. And we got a Ryan Bliss for Arizona. Heriberto Hernandez to 125 for TV. The prices will probably go down a little bit, but I don't really think as much, to be honest. There's still other triple logo mans and other dual and single logo mans that people are looking for. And at the end of the day, I mean, if Anthony Edwards, LaMelo Ball, you know, all the top rookies continue to perform and be superstars in the NBA, it's only going to continue to go up. Even if, like, some of these hits have been pulled, because you're still looking for, like, the RPAs out of there, you know, et cetera, et cetera. But no, I think it'll still stay relatively high. It could drop a little bit. I wouldn't be shocked if it dropped a couple thousand a box, but it'll still be pretty expensive. It's not like it's going to go back down to, like, less than $10,000 or $10,000 a box. It's still going to stay up there. All right, guys, so there's the first four boxes there. Let me just top load all the autographs. But what, like, the NFL should do to kind of copy what they did is make, like, a dual NFL Shield Brady. Something like that, since he has two different teams. I bet you that would sell really well. All right, let's go with the next four, guys. I don't know, battle. I wouldn't think more than 4,000 or 5,000. Usually it's just a handful of them in the thousands, and then there's a couple of them that are 2,000, 3,000, 4,000. I don't think anything more than that. Yeah, Jason, it did sell out. I think Carl got the last spots. I said if it sold out before I finished this, I would break it. So, yeah. So, probably won't break until like 10:40, 10:45 Pacific. So, we can come back in a little bit. But, yes, I will be breaking that. Second to last box. So again, it took me about like 22 minutes or so to finish the first four boxes. So I'm thinking that I should be done with this in about like 15, 17 minutes. So I think the whole break in general should take about 45 minutes, maybe 50 the most. In about like 20 minutes, I should be done with this. In a few minutes to print out labels, put the break away, and like I said, I should be ready to start breaking that NT around 10:40, 10:45, and then that'll be our last break of the night. Just some base card here. I moved on the top. All right, last few packs here, guys. Coolio, guys. There you go. We have a Brandon Valenzuela. First purple. Right. Ryan Mountcastle to $4.99. And a Ian Lewis to $99. Nice color right there. Pedro Piñera. Khalil Watson. And then we got our Gavin Conticello for the Diamondbacks. Dustin Harris for Texas. And Fidel Montero to $2.99. Our first box done. Let's go to the next one. And we got Lorenzo to $4.99 for the Houston Astros. Lucas Trish. Royals. It's going to Andrew Song. And Luis Gonzalez for Baltimore. Kenneth Al with that one. Daniel Lopez to $3.99. Robert Hassel. We got Justice Thompson to $2.50. Alright, next box, guys. Actually, there's an autograph right there. Valenzuela. Gold Shimmer, Zach Sunwinski for the Pirates. It's going to Chad out of 50. Is that a good color? Is that a good player right there? I think I gotta get to see the back of the stats. Fifteenth round pick. I don't even know they have that many runs. Jackson, Troy. And we got Lucas Tresh. Sunwinski. And we got Ryan Blist of 299 Speckle. First for Arizona. Second round pick, 42nd overall out of Burbank. Maybe this guy's got potential. Alright guys, down to the final box. Good luck everybody. Go first, Alvin Guzman to $3.99. Mike Cole for Pittsburgh Paper. Blue. And we got Jonathan Place out of 250. I believe someone said he was a good one right there too for the Mariners. Seattle Mariners going to Josh. We have Randy Vasquez, pitcher first for the Yankees, Speckle. Darren Baker, first purple. Green Cabrian Hayes. Last one here is Garcia, sorry. Hoser. Post-war. And a Kevin Alcantara to 199. That was to Philly there for the autograph. That is Josh as well. Alrighty, guys, and there you go. That was the break. So I'll do a quick little recap on the autographs. Let me just top load these last 12 autos that we got here. Some good colors, but I don't know about the prospects, though. None of the big names that I was looking for my little sheet. But the good thing is that a lot of these kids are really young. Hope they have a lot of future value. Alright guys, here we go. Autograph wise. Valenzuela to 250 for San Diego. Gavin Conceicello for Arizona. Harris for Texas, Lorenzo for Houston, Tresh for KC, Gonzalez for Baltimore Orioles, Valenzuela again for San Diego, Sunwinski for 250, Shimmer Gold for the Pirates, Bliss Speckle to 299 for the Diamondbacks, Vasquez for the Yankees, Garcia for Philly, Clase to 250 for Seattle, Sunwinski again, Albright for the Angels, Atomic, Angeles to 499 for the Padres, Bailey for the Sox, Gonzalez Purple to 250 for the Astros, Frazier for Pirates Refractor, Genovas for the Giants Speckle, Lara Yellow for Washington, Cabrera for the Yankees, Aguilar for the Minnesota Twins, Lara Blue for Washington again, and then Ryan Bliss. So I believe that was 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24. Yeah, 24 autographs. And then we had a lot of nice color here, of course, that we're also going to be top loading, penny sleeving, or pennies are top loading the shipping team will. Right over here as well. So, yeah, got some good colors there. So, appreciate it, guys. This was a Bowman Jumbo number 4. 5 is in the store. Let's run it for tomorrow, guys. JaspysCaseBreaks.com.